Can a same case with same parties, with same title, with same subject matter fought in different court at the same time? Hey guys, welcome to my legal classes. This is Ganesh Pujari and today we are going to learn section 10, which is all about stay of suit or res sub judice. Now this is part of part 1, which discusses about suits in general, which covers from section 9 to section 35B of CPC, and we are going to focus on section 10, which is all about stay of suit or res sub judice. What is this all about? Let's try understand in just 2 slides of mine. Let's get into the first slide. Section 10 deals with stay of suit, and if you want to see that in Latin, that means res sub judice. And the term meaning of sub judice is under judgment. When two or more cases are filed between the same parties on the same subject matter, the competent court has power to stay proceedings. That, for example, you have a case and you have the same title, same subject matter and same parties. If you are trying to take the same suit in a different court, then a court can stop all the proceedings, which is all about stay of suit. Now let us try understand section 10 in detail. I have brought it in simple English. Let us try understand term by term. To apply section 10, one of the first and foremost requirement is there should be a trial of suit which is in pending status. Only when there is a trial of suit which is in pending status, there can be question of section 10. Otherwise, it can't raise. So, when a trial of suit is pending, no court shall proceed with the trial of such suit. Now, how to decide whether it is same suit or not? There are 3 important conditions to see. 1, the parties are same. 2, it is of the same title. And 3, the subject matter is directly or substantially is same. So, when a trial of such suit is pending, no court shall proceed with the same suit. That is all about section 10. The next important aspect that we need to understand is what are the different court involved here. Because I have already made a statement that no court shall proceed with the trial of such suit. If I am saying no court, which are the different courts? It can be the same court or it can be any other court in India having jurisdiction to grant the relief claimed, or it can be any court beyond the limits of India established or continued by the central government, or it may be the Supreme Court of India. None of these courts shall proceed with such particular trial of suit which is pending. But there is one exception. If the suit is pending with foreign court, then the Indian courts can hear such cause. Now that is one important exception. However, if it is any court in India or any court having jurisdiction to hear and give relief to that particular case, or any court which is beyond Indian limits but continued by the central government, or even the Supreme Court cannot hear such suit, but only when it is any other foreign court, then the Indian court can hear such suit. To consider for stay of suits or res sub judice, there are 6 important conditions to be satisfied. I'll just read out those 6 points, which are very, very easy. First being, there must be 2 or more suits in which one is the original and then the others are subsequent suits. The second one, it should be between the same parties, and if any party is not there, maybe of their successors. The third requirement is it should be for the same subject matter, and the fourth one is it should be with the same title. If you read 2nd, 3rd and 4th, it should be between the same parties, it should be for the same subject matter, and the 4th one is it is for the same title. The sameness is very important here. The 5th condition is the court where the suit was filed previously should be competent to grant the relief. That is one of the most important requirement. If the court where the suit was previously filed, if it is not competent to grant the relief, of course, the case can be taken to other courts. That is very, very easy and important. And the last point is such suit should be pending in the same court or any other court in India having jurisdiction to grant the relief claimed, or any court beyond the limits of India established or continued by the central government and having like jurisdiction or before the Supreme Court. Wherever you are seeing that this case cannot be taken. However, if it is pending with the foreign court, then an Indian court can run that particular suit. That is all about 6 important conditions. With that, I am concluding my discussion on res sub judice. What next? The section 11, which is all about res judicata. With that, give me permission to take off. Thank you so much for subscribing my channel. Please like, share and comment my videos. All the very best for whatsoever purpose you are watching my videos. And thanks again.